Recently, someone had asked me why they keep dropping stitches. This is common on some machines. In this person's case, it's when they're increasing. Now, this is similar to the bond because I cannot take and push my lever here like the LK140 I have or a few of my other machines. So any stitches in holding position will be knit back. So first of all, I would suggest on the simple increases, you're going to bring a needle out to holding position. You're going to knit across. It puts the yarn over that hook. Now push that back to the forward working position. Again, I'm going to increase on that side. Knit across. Now, because I have no weight there, I either need to hang a claw weight on the ends and keep moving it up as I go, or if you don't have claw weights, you could get some forks and you could bend them to be your claw weights. But what I like doing is I will just take that needle on the end that doesn't have the weight under it. Well, I do need to have that one out to hold in position to increase. But this one here, because it has a stitch on it, I will put that into the forward working position. So it's going to knit that stitch, but it's going to wrap over this one. So I bring the next needle out to hold. Oh, I got to put that back to forward working position. I take the last needle that was knitted over here, forward and then back. On the bond machines, make sure that latch is open. You're probably going to drop more stitches that way if you don't have the open latches. And once you get enough stitches increased as you need, then go ahead and hang that weight on the ends. If you're using a fork weight, what you can do also is take some washers or some nuts, thread some yarn or string through those, and hang it on the hoop here so it makes it heavier and sits on the fabric a little bit better. So I hope this answers that person's question and that they could do the increase in on that article they're making and not have the stitches drop off on them.